Tonight, number 2, North Carolina, comes to Comcast to take on Maryland in yet another important ACC matchup. The boys from Blue Heaven have been cruising through a season of smooth sailing. Maryland's journey has been a roller coaster ride of emotional highs and lows in the Anything Can Happen ACC. Second-ranked North Carolina in Terrapin territory. It's one of those that you circle on your calendar every college basketball season. ACC Sunday Night Hoops is now. On this cold February night, fans anticipate a breakthrough game with the Ides of March just around the corner as number 2 North Carolina comes into the Comcast Center to meet Maryland. ACC Sunday Night Hoops presented by Staples. There you see the standings in the ACC. Carolina perched at the top, and for Maryland, trying to get above the 500 mark in the very muddled ACC middle. And the John Gilchrist, Raymond Felton story will be documented many times over in a league that's guard-laden. These two are among the best. Hello, everyone. I'm Tim Brando. And there's no question tonight, North Carolina trying to solidify themselves as a number one seed. Maryland trying to get inside the bubble rather than outside. And when you start talking about Rashad McCants, not here for the second consecutive game. So as I bring in my man, the G-man, the question is, can Carolina keep this smooth sail going without McCants for a second straight game?
Well, you know, they're going to try to bring it home, Tim. And it's, you know, they hit the buoy leaving port against Santa Clara in the first game, but then they ripped off 14 in a row and were well on their way. The only squalls they ran into out at sea were at Duke and at Wake Forest, but since then they've been on a roll, and they are clearly a number one seed in the NCAA tournament.
For Gary Williams, he's hanging his head right now on the sweep of Duke, but they've been swept by North Carolina State and Clemson, a rocky road
ladies
for them.
Yeah,
they really need to smooth things out as this season
America
comes to an end, but it has been dizzying heights. You talk about sweeping Duke and then the gut-wrenching lows, a loss at home to Clemson, getting swept by NC State. Gary Williams thinks that defense is the thing that's going to bring this team back to the level they were last year.
In that matchup, you might recall, against Clemson, he had a shuttle bus with starters leaving, subs leaving, and the like.
Yeah, he was down to his team managers. I really think that's who he wanted to play at the end of the game. And Gary's been sending a lot of messages this year, and I don't think there's going to be any question that this team is going to be ready for this opponent tonight.
We're going to give you more red carpet treatment when we continue with our pregame festivities. The third member of our broadcast team, Dwayne Ballin, when we come back to the Comcast Center as Maryland prepares to take on number 2 and trying harder.
Welcome back to ACC Sunday Night Hoops. I'm Dwayne Ballin here at the Comcast Center in College Park. Maryland fans are beginning to file into this arena for the second meeting of the season with the North Carolina Tar Heels. Our ACC flashback now takes us back to the first meeting between these two back at Chapel Hill Smith Center. Ranked number 22 at the time, Maryland led midway through the first half with an aggressive defense that created myriad turnovers. But then number 3 North Carolina started forcing its turnovers and shut down the Terrapins the rest of the way. Raymond Felton started a surge on this assist to Jawad Williams, and moments later he was the recipient of this alley-oop pass from Rashad McCants. The Tar Heels had 7 players in double figures, led by McCants with 17. Tonight's query, what is Gary Williams' plan to avoid another encounter like this?
The thing I learned was that you have to really run your offense well if you expect to compete against North Carolina, because they take advantage of every bad shot you take. They're probably as good a transition team as there is in the country, and if you give them chances to get into their transition, they're really difficult to stop.
Williams Terrapins feel this is a must-win game against the first-place Tar Heels tonight. The players are getting ready. Tim Brando and Mike Jaminski will have the call coming up next as ACC Sunday Night Hoops continues.
Hey! ACC Sunday Night Hoops is presented by Staples. That was easy. And brought to you in part by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge. Roy Williams, the winningest active coach in America today, bringing his team out. And here's the Staples starting lineup for the Tar Heels. So very consistent. Jack Emanuel, the designated defender. Jawad Williams, perhaps the most underpublicized improved player on the squad. May, Felton, and Scott. Gary Williams, 3 years removed from a national championship himself, understands what this team must do tonight and the starting five that he presents. Nick Kaner-Medley, who's been an all-league performer at times. Grinnan does get the start as a senior. Good for him. This is senior night. Travis Garrison and company. Let's take a look now at the Dodge game plan, G-Man.
For North Carolina, they want to defend the flex offense inside and take care of the ball. Even though they beat Maryland, they had 24 turnovers in that first game. And for the Terrapins, they want to try to contain Raymond Felton, and they must be active on the glass. They were outboarded by 20 in the first game by the Tar Heels.
Nice to see that Gary Williams has allowed Michael Grinnan. He's got the ball right now, the opportunity to start on this senior night. He's been playing quite a bit of late, and in fact, you look back at some of those wins against Duke, he had some very meaningful free throws to help them out. Nice move by McCray, unable to finish. May with the rebound, outlet to Felton. Down to 10. Felton with the dump down to May. No double team coming, and Sean May takes advantage.
But Tim, I don't know if there's been a more consistent low post man in the league over the last six or seven games. I mean, Sean May has been averaging a double-double in that stretch.
Kaner-Medley, from a matchup standpoint, can be difficult for the Tar Heels to deal with. I think it's this side of the floor, though, Mike, where it's very important early on to see how the Terrapins respond.
You know, defensively, and you know, a little turnover and sloppy play. And this is something that happened in the first game, that they had North Carolina 13 turnovers in the first 13 minutes. And this will be a little bit of a challenge for Jawad Williams. Kaner-Medley, pretty nice, good job of putting the ball on the floor.
He can beat you driving to the basket. He does have an excellent face-up game. And that fadeaway is not a bad shot for him. Gilchrist over Felton. And again, the size and strength of Gilchrist can at times be an advantage against the smaller Raymond Felton.
The one thing he has to work on, though, Tim, is not to get sucked into an individual battle with Raymond Felton out there. He still has to run this team. And they're having a little conversation right now during the course of the game.
And Scott with the poor pass. He and Williams got crossed up. So two rather ugly turnovers for North Carolina in their last possession.
Yeah, those are just mental lapses. Yeah. As a coach, you think you can deal with the physical things, but it's the mental lapses that really kill you, especially on the road.
Two of them unforced. Garrison over May. Too strong. Felton takes it down off the deck.
And that type of shot just bails Sean May out. You'd rather attack him, try to get some fouls on him.
Jawad Williams with the triple.
He's a guy you touched on, Tim, during the lineup thing. He just gets overshadowed by the star on this team. And he's been consistent all year long.
Well, you heard what Gary Williams said about him today when we spoke. He said, you know, this guy just plays.
Yep.
He doesn't get much attention, but he brings it every night.
And, you know, happy for him that they are having the season that they are, trying to erase that 8-20 year early in his career.
Turnover by Kaner-Medley. Felton got his hands involved. Garrison from the backside picks it away. Tough pass out of bounds. Last touch by North Carolina. Gilchrist had a nice idea. Good defensive work by Roy Williams' team, who has played magnificent defense. You see, they got 24 turnovers in that first meeting in Chapel Hill.
And that's what you want to do. You want to try to make Kaner-Medley go right. Let him finish that. Most times he will pull up for the jump shot going that way.
Felton gives it up to May. And the foul spotted as Sean puts it on the deck. Gary Williams disagrees. It will go against Chris McCray.
You know, one of the things, both of these teams love to run the basketball in the top three scoring in the conference. And so for both of them, transition defense is going to be a premium in this game.
Marvin Williams, the sensational freshman, checks in for Jawad Williams. Manuel over Grinnan, rejected by Garrison. Painter Medley leads the Terrapins down the floor. Gilchrist. That one was knocked away by Scott. Maryland will control it on their end of the floor.
Boy, and Gary Williams is just irate, telling John Gilchrist, run the offense. That jump shot way early in the shot clock. This Carolina team, you've got to explore all your options.
And particularly, you see the bump by Scott. There are times, we talk so often about Gary Williams' flex offense, and I don't know if people really understand and comprehend what we mean by that, but against North Carolina, they have some matchup advantages with that.
Well, it's a series of up screens and baseline screens if you're formed in a box. But the problem was with the offense this year, Tim, that they don't have a true low post presence that offense really requires. They've always had that stud down low for duck-ins to get easy shots.
Painter Medley on the dribble drive. Gilchrist in traffic, counted, and the foul.
Well, John Gilchrist at 5.3 rebounds, one of the best rebounding point guards in the country. We talk about his strength inside. A lot of times, you know, it's not always the greatest idea to have your point guard lingering around the offensive glass, but after inbounding that ball, it just came right to him.
He gets the old-fashioned three-point play. 7-5, and Gilchrist has 5 with the Terps 7. Is this place jumping?
Well, senior night, and this is an extremely important game for Maryland. Many feel that a win here would solidify their NCAA hopes.
Felton with a three ball.
Well, including me.
Yeah.
And I think probably you.
Absolutely. An 8-8 finish with the wins that they have on their resume. And, of course, remember, they've still got to play Virginia Tech, a team that's had a really good year but played very poorly over the weekend against North Carolina State. Grinnan. That one was rejected by Manuel. Out of bounds to the Terrapins when we come back. End to end. This could be one of those games. First one to triple digits wins. Guards getting it done early on.
Step onto the field. Electrify the last row. Take the ultimate ride. Shatter records. Start a movement. Greatness won't come to you. You have to reach for it. Bass, reach for greatness.
Silverado Half-Ton Crew comes standard with more muscle than Ford, Dodge, or Toyota. That's why it's the right truck. The official truck of an American revolution.
Stronger denim. More comfortable. Relaxed fit. Wrangler 5-star premium quality denim. Wrangler. Real comfortable jeans.
This April, Phoenix International Raceway brings you NASCAR in a whole new light. PIR's first Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night NASCAR weekend will only heat up when the sun goes down. So get your tickets now. Watch the NASCAR Busch Series and NASCAR Nextel Cup Series racers start their battles at twilight and finish under the lights April 21st through 23rd at PIR. Call 1-866-408-RACE for the best seats available or log on to phoenixraceway.com. It's NASCAR in a whole new light.
North Carolina leads by one in the opening moments. Not at all what we saw. We witnessed earlier in the week against Clemson when the Tigers had their way getting to the basket. Gary Williams pulled out the starters, brought in the subs. Pretty soon he made another decision. We asked him about that earlier today.
Well, in the Clemson game, I took the starters out. Then I took the subs out that went in for the starters. And then my assistant coaches didn't want to play, so I had to go back with the starters.
I think mystifying might be the best word for Gary and this team this year, that they had the wins they do. Memphis early in the year was a top 25 team, sweeping Duke, beating Georgia Tech, and then losing at home to Clemson. And really have just been all over the map.
Shot clock at two, McCray. That's a big hoop right there. And Williams, don't blink. Count the basket. Kaner Medley had it. You have to have the floor balanced. North Carolina, that's textbook, getting it down the floor.
No team in basketball does a better job of transition after a made basket than North Carolina. You almost have to take a couple of bodies off the offensive glass and give that up to just to get people back and bodies back.
Offensive foul. Spotted against Maryland. May have been an illegal pick.
And might we add that that was Marvin Williams at 6'9 running the floor. So that's what really puts a lot of pressure on your big people to get back.
Harrison picked up the foul, and David Noel is coming to the game now for North Carolina, the junior from Durham, North Carolina, who always brings it on the defensive end.
Well, he and Manuel may be the best 1-2 punch defensively at that position in the game.
May finds Scott for three. Oh, the iron unkind, but it's pulled down by May. And he finally gets it to roll through.
Basket by Sean May.
Now, Sean May, 14.4 rebounds his last five, and must get a body on him on the offensive glass.
Kaner Medley with a leaner. And we're tied at a dozen apiece. Felton. Both teams really taking it to the rack. And by the way, that was the 1,000th point on that leaner for Kaner Medley. Brennan lost it on the way to the deck, and it's picked up by Felton.
Brennan not just out there starting for show, Tim. He's gotten,
he's
played six early minutes here. Very meaningful.
There's a backdoor cut by Scott. Good defensive help by Maryland.
Kaner Medley able to get over there just in time to slow up the progress and break up the layup.
Marvin Williams checking Kaner Medley. As good as he is, there are times when he will make some mistakes on ball fakes and the like. I think Gary Williams wouldn't mind seeing him have an opportunity to touch it inside. Does not get the reversal to go. Noel, outlet to Scott. A steal by Gilchrist. Boy, North Carolina has turned it over five times. McCray again.
The coaching staff is very concerned about turnovers coming into this game, Tim, and it has hurt them so far. Maryland has capitalized on most of them.
Six for McCray, the junior from Capitol Heights, Maryland. May. McCray the rebound. Kaner Medley cherry picking.
We thought we might see a high-scoring affair here. It's shaping up like a 100-point night for both teams.
I'd say the first one to get there gets the W. Maryland on a 7-0 run. Noel left free. This is a Tar Heels team that's got tremendous balance. Even opening, they can take advantage.
But that's what shows you the respect for Raymond Felton. Both players going to him. Brennan kind of sliding over and giving Noel, rather than giving a drive up to Felton, letting him take a three-point shot.
Gilchrist off the bounce, too strong. Garrison had it, stripped by Noel. Gary Williams pounding his arm. He felt there was a foul. Marvin Williams up top. Well, if he makes that shot, that signals a long night usually for the opposition.
And felony charge. I mean, that should be illegal if he can. And he has been knocking down that shot. It's in his repertoire.
Harrison, too strong. Marvin Williams, the outlet. The good news is Maryland's playing better defense. The bad news, the flow of the game has it going up and down. And no team runs as well as North Carolina.
That's a, you know, we thought coming in that Maryland might want to try and control the tempo a little bit, but Gilchrist is bent on getting this game up and down. Yep. In fact, he was just yelling a little bit at Kaner Medley for not filling the block and getting down in the transition.
Gilchrist trying to post up Felton. Painter Medley takes the jumper and fails. Noel in traffic, Brennan the rebound. Give and go maneuver, but it's disrupted by Noel. I believe we're going to get an overrule here from Carl Hess. Maryland should have the ball and does.
Good piece of officiating that time by Carl Hess and Ray Natilli, who along with Mike Wood are a part of the crew. They're slipping out for easy ones early on at College Park.
A symptom checker that allows people to isolate the warning signs of an illness and understand what they mean. Assessment tools that summarize risks and treatment options to discuss with their physicians. Just some of the features that make WebMD America's most trusted and most visited health site. Recommended by more physicians and relied on by more than 20 million Americans every month. WebMD, America's health site.
What is this stuff?
Ooh. Yeah, Mr. Spooky. That's a joke. Seriously.
The new Dodge Magnum.
Snow? In the bayou?
Available with all-wheel drive. Performance and versatility for the unexpected. This winter, grab the new 2005 Dodge Magnum and save big with $1,000 in February bonus cash. Now at your Dodge dealer.
The way we dribble up and down the court. I like slam dunks that take me to the hoop. My favorite play is the alley oop.
We're playing basketball.
Find scores, find tickets, find just what you're after with the new, more precise MSN search.
Arizona Biker Leathers is the place to go for the finest selection in motorcycle apparel, parts, and accessories for men, women, and children. Known for fine quality merchandise at unheard of low prices, Arizona Biker Leathers makes finding what you want easy, convenient, and affordable. So ride over to your quality leather connection at 19th Avenue in Thunderbird, where it's always worth a trip. The family owned and operated Arizona Biker Leathers. Arizona Biker Leathers, 602-843-5847.
Thursday, Pac-10 College Hoops returns. 14th-ranked Washington fresh off that win against Arizona. We'll be taking on California. Coverage begins at 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific time. Tim Brando, Mike Kaminsky, Wayne Ballin, happy to have you with us. Maryland leading by two, a frenetic pace in the first 9 minutes of our game tonight. We expected that, and that's exactly what it's been. Ray inbounds for Maryland. Ledbetter, Sterling Ledbetter into the game for the first time. The junior out of Laurel, Maryland. Gives it to McCray. Gist is also on the floor. James Gist for the first time. And North Carolina counters in the backcourt. Quentin Thomas on the deck now along with Terry.
Well, Roy Williams told us before the game that he'd like to try to limit Raymond Felton's minutes and get Thomas out on the floor a little bit more. He'd like him in the 30 to 32 range against North Carolina State, had to play him 38.
Yeah, and you know, I think he got lulled into that because Raymond played so well that particular night, had control of the game all the way through. It may have been the best game he had played since they had been out at Maui individually against Iowa.
And most teams try when Felton's out of game to apply pressure to Thomas. Let's see if Maryland can do that.
Juwan Williams steps out for the tray. May keeping it alive again. Back up and fouled. Obikwe had a hand in there, and he'll pick up the personal foul. Again, you have Obikwe. Sophomore from Carson, California. Let's go over to Dwayne Ballin.
Tim and Mike, I talked to Nick Kaner-Medley before the game, and I asked him, you know, about the importance of this game, and he recognized that. He says, but you know, what Coach Williams has really been trying to get us to understand is we have to understand the big game doesn't necessarily have a direct correlation with the name on the opposing jersey. Clemson was just as big a game as this North Carolina game is. They have to become consistent. He says their backs are to the wall, and they do understand that now.
Yeah, frankly, this is not one of those games where he should have an issue with how hard his team plays.
But, you know, you look at it, and, you know, and Dwayne's right. If they take care of business against Clemson, they're sitting there at 8-6 than 7-7, and they've taken a lot of pressure off themselves.
Gist was looking to work give and go, but it was taken away by Noel.
Off the baseline extended.
Well, they feel, I talked about the lack of a low post presence, and they feel eventually like Gist can be that guy in a nice little bump and fadeaway jump shot.
Noel with the bounce pass entry. Williams gets rid of it. Rod Williams driving, and boy, is he good now with the ball driving to the basket.
Well, all career highs and all his shooting numbers.
McCray, with a vengeance, takes it to the rack. And he is fouled by Rashawn Terry, sophomore from Winston-Salem.
Talk about Chris McCray and what he can do. He certainly brings the three-point shot. Struggled early in that category against North Carolina. 0-for-6 in their first matchup, but has knocked down 2-of-3 here in this game. Gilchrist out, nice look ahead, triggering the break to Kaner Medley.
I saw a wonderful sign a moment ago from one of the fans. You see Jackie Manuel coming back behind the Maryland bench, and the sign read, "Pretend they're Duke." You certainly wouldn't want them to pretend they're Clemson or NC State.
I don't think you need to pretend anything against the number two team in the country.
John Gilchrist comes back onto the floor. McCray takes the seat with six. Quentin Thomas out. Raymond Felton back on the floor for North Carolina as well.
But you've said it many times over, Mike. One of the things coaches, particularly this time of the year, don't want to have to deal with is coaching effort.
And again, Juwad Williams taking it in hard, and he's hammered by Ibikwe.
Yeah, you know, and that should be a given right from October 15, you know, going in. That's the thing you expect when you recruit these kids, and you know what's inside of them.
Will Bowers is going to come into the game very quickly. Let's go back over to Dwayne Ballin. Dwayne?
Tim and Mike, you mentioned earlier about Juwad Williams not getting recognition. I asked him that very thing during warm-ups tonight, and he looked at me and laughed. He said, you know, it really doesn't matter. These guys on this team know I lead. He's having the most satisfying year of his career at Carolina with a qualifier, and you know that means St. Louis.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think he's become one of the real emotional leaders for this team.
Well, you know what, Tim, he's had a lot invested in this year. There are a lot of, he's certainly seen the absolute lowest of lows in this program's history, maybe. And to erase that, I think this year has been absolutely critical.
Powers is stripped. Kaner Medley, counted and a foul.
One of the things Gary Williams talked about coming off the Clemson game was getting to loose balls and offensive rebounds, and the Terrapins have been very quick to the ball in this start. And I'll tell you what, that was a nice look inside. Kaner Medley in the right place at the right time, and they would like to see him operate a little bit more in the paint. He's knocked down a three in this game, but he's so very strong inside. He puts a lot of pressure on you.
Nick has been very impressive. And aggressive, he's taken the ball to the hole nine times in this game.
There was a stretch a month ago, Tim, I thought he was first team all ACC. I mean, he was playing on that high a level. He's dipped a little bit, but has regained his form.
Particularly after that Duke game at Cameron Indoor Stadium.
Manuel, nice look to Terry, and again the foul. And the rotation over. Not there, it'll go against Gist. First foul on James Gist.
You watch this nice basket cut right down here. When you do that hard, good things happen. The middle of the defense just opened up for Maryland, and Rashawn Terry waltzed right down the lane. Really astounding thing about that first game, that North Carolina was 4 points away from 9 players in double figures. Yeah. I mean, that's unbelievable.
Well, with all due respect to Rashad McCants, who's an outstanding player. We've watched now more than 10 plus minutes of this first half. And it's not as if North Carolina's hurting. You know what I mean? They would love to have him, don't get me wrong. But this team is so deep and so balanced that they can absorb a loss of an all-league performer. Few in this conference could.
The only guy they can't do without is number two.
Yep.
That's it. I mean, they could suffer through just about, you know, Sean May would put a pressure on them for sure being out. But Raymond Felton is an absolute must if they are going to go to St. Louis.
By the way, Sean May with that last tooth now has 8 points. And we're tied at 24. Powers goes to the right hand and gets it up and over May.
That's the first points he scored in four games. But again, they want to put pressure on Sean May. They think that they can get him in foul trouble, and you do that by going aggressively to the basket.
And that means more minutes for Bowers. A rejection of Marvin Williams, a pilfer by Felton. May, yes, and a foul.
Sean May making an offensive statement here early in this game, and we've talked about it, Tim, that he may have the best hands in the ACC for a big man right now. This was a terrific catch. Here's the look inside and the block.
Sean May.
Then Raymond Felton tracks it down, and it turns into a three-point play for Sean May.
You know, that's another one of those situations, too, where it was a loose ball situation in Maryland. They were beaten to the ball, and that's something Gary Williams does not want to see. He'll take more of that. Gilchrist and one. Timeout, 7:54 remaining in the opening half. Terps playing with tenacity against the number two Tar Heels at home in College Park.
Hey, Bob here for Quiznos. Did you hear Quiznos is now offering their steakhouse beef dip sub for just $2.99 every day? It's stacked high with tender, juicy roast beef, melted Swiss cheese, and it's all oven toasted on their awesome bread. It even comes with pan-roasted au jus for dipping. Man, I wish I had the motor skills to dip one of those bad boys.
Get our Steakhouse Beef Dip Sub. It's loaded with tender roast beef and toasted to perfection for just $2.99 every day.
Just $2.99 every day.
Quiznos. Toasty.
And now we have to get to our traffic report. Let's do that. How about that traffic report?
Traffic is horrible this morning. I get the feeling.
People are trying to get to work this morning.
Speaking of introducing the Acura RL with the first real-time traffic monitoring system through AcuraLink. It can help you find an open road. And with 300 horsepower and the world's most advanced all-wheel drive, it knows what to do when it gets there.
We're really trying to get you the traffic.
Oh, you know what? My mother forced me to take that in.
The all-new Acura RL.
When two great things come together, that's the sweet spot. Introducing the most powerful mid-sized truck, period. The all-new 265 horsepower Nissan Frontier. Welcome to the sweet spot.
On the next Head-to-Head with James Brown, go inside the lives of the world champion Boston Red Sox and NASCAR's reigning Nextel Cup champion, Kurt Busch. Tomorrow on FSN.
The best damn sports show, period. Join Tom Arnold and John Sally as they cut loose with the biggest stars in sports and entertainment.
He's got it down!
Oh, my God.
Weeknights on FSN.
It is Oscar night, as everyone knows, and we certainly are keeping with the tradition here on ACC Sunday Night Hoops. How about our first installment of a Foxy Award? Player of the Year, and I believe you and I both agree, J.J. Redick. You, though, with a little trepidation up until about 2 weeks ago, right?
Yeah, I was leaning towards Sheldon Williams on that, but I'll tell you what, Tim, the actual vote's out there. And it may not be decided until after the Duke Carolina game, because certainly Raymond Felton is in that discussion.
Absolutely.
And you know how guys like to hold on to their vote. And, you know, Chris Paul was the preseason player of the year, but I think both Raymond Felton and J.J. Redick have moved past him.
Now, picking first and second teams is so difficult, particularly with all the outstanding guard play that we have
in the Atlantic Coast Conference this season.
Now keep in mind, too, in the first game of this series, the score and time were virtually the same, but then Carolina went on an incredible run and took a 47-34 halftime lead. So I'm sure Gary Williams reminded his team of that. They have to finish the half out.
Marvin Williams, ball was deflected. Felton recovered it, and the runner goes.
His offensive game has really stepped up. 49% from the floor, 46 from behind the arc. He is just shooting lights out all year long.
Maryland's three top season scorers have been the difference early on tonight. McCray, Gilchrist, and Kaner Medley.
I think Bowers that time wasted a dribble before he knew where May was playing him. He put the ball on the floor and took himself out of the play.
Those three players, Mike, that I just mentioned have 25 of the 29 scored so far. Gilchrist unable to add to it, and May brings it down. That was a good defensive sequence for North Carolina.
Melvin Scott on the wing. An air ball. Kaner Medley retrieves it.
Gist. Gilchrist trying to keep it alive, but May with the outlet to Scott.
Again, I think you bail the player out by shooting that jump shot. Now, Marvin Williams, too good a defensive player, just got up and got a little piece of the ball.
Felton off the pick, takes advantage.
You know the body language, John Gilchrist shaking his head, slumping down a little bit. It looks like he wants to say, all right, I need to get back into the fray here and get into a little battle with Felton, but that's not what Maryland needs right now.
The ongoing issues with Gilchrist and his decision-making with Gary Williams has been part of this most recent Maryland slump.
Nice matchup outside to Jackie Manuel on Kaner Medley. He's been denying him the ball this whole possession.
There's a quality look, but Bowers unable to finish. Gilchrist with a nice pass. Carolina looks to add to their two-point lead.
Right now, defensively, North Carolina funneling the shots to both Bowers and Gist, willing to take their chances with those two.
May. Not there. And the foul spotted. Go against the...
And I believe they're going to say it was out of bounds. Yes, it's just out of bounds. No whistle.
Juwan Williams comes back onto the floor for May. Marvin Williams also sits down.
And David Noel back on the floor for North Carolina. They'll trigger it in. Felton leaves it for Juwan Williams, who's hammered by Kaner Medley.
And next week, ACC Sunday Night Hoops returns when sixth-ranked Wake Forest battles North Carolina State. A showdown between Tobacco Road rivals. Coverage begins at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific. And Mike, we could be talking about an NCAA tournament berth for NC State at stake. We could be talking about a number one seed for Wake Forest. A lot on the line. And frankly, you probably can't get the ACC tournament seeding set until after you've seen that game.
Absolutely. I mean, the things are so muddled, and right now teams must concentrate, Tim, for the first time ever about getting to number four or five, because you don't want to be playing on Thursday in the Big East tournament. No team that's ever played in that first round has ever gone on to win the tournament. It's just too much of a grind, four games in 4 days.
Carolina in the midst of a 7-0 spurt. Ledbetter has come onto the floor now, replacing Gilchrist. Operating at the point with Garrison, Ebekwe, McCray, and Kaner Medley. Off the pick from Ebekwe. Just through iron. Williams with the rebound for North Carolina.
And Jackie Manuel has really gotten into Kaner Medley defensively.
Ledbetter leads the attack and helps claim the turnover. Gary Williams really working over Ray Natilli.
Raymond Felton checks out.
There's a look, and they're saying that foul occurred right at the end, but you get the next best thing, you get the possession.
Yep.
But Gary can never be completely happy.
Garrison, good baseline pass. Wave it off, foul prior to the shot. Against Noel. That was an excellent baseline pass.
But you can see, Tim, how far out North Carolina has got Maryland extended and where they initiate their offense. And that was a nice play inside. Cubs. So we'll keep an eye on how smoothly this offense runs without John Gilchrist in the game.
That was just the sixth team foul against North Carolina. Beckway in traffic, forced to adjust. Nothing comes easily against North Carolina, and they get it back.
If you're Maryland right now, and they've done a decent job, you can't worry about arguing with the referee. That split second that your attention is taken away, North Carolina's rushing it up the floor.
Maryland scoreless in the last 3.5 minutes. Very rarely can you get away with that against a team as potent offensively as the Tar Heels. Leading this league in scoring, Maryland not far behind. Tar Heels averaging just a little under 90, and Maryland not that far behind.
That's another one of the reasons why we thought we'd see a game that could approach 100 tonight.
But the difference has been defensively. The numbers for North Carolina, scary. And a nice little stand right there, having to burn a timeout on the sideline out of bounds.
.407 remaining, and John Gilchrist has had his moments early on in the game, but again, maintaining a level, that's the issue tonight.
Well, and you know, he's got 8 points and shooting the ball pretty well, 3 of 6 from the floor. But I think the issue all season long is, you know, how does Gary Williams rate John Gilchrist's performance, and how John Gilchrist rates his own performance as a point guard?
Well, we had this discussion earlier today with Gary Williams, and by the way, I'll preface this statement by saying there are a lot of guys in the coaching profession that we all think a lot of, and I think Gary Williams would be in that group. We asked him about how do you attribute the issues with this team, particularly, he said, look, when we play well and our team gets credit, I think our players see it as individual credit. We need them to see it as a team that played well. And again, a nice look inside, and the bucket goes to Quentin Thomas.
Not a big-time scorer. So that is his 20th field goal attempt in 27 games. So he is a pass-first, pass-second, pass-third point guard.
I thought that spoke volumes when Gary told us that, Mike. And really, when you live in major metropolitan areas like this Maryland team does, there's Jones from 40 feet. That was a poor decision. McCray for a three-pointer, and he knocks it down. I mean, a lot of times the media goes to the individual as opposed to the team. And I think at times a young club will not respond as a team, as Jack Emanuel answers with a three.
Right, and you have to realize that as the team gets better and as the team is rewarded, each individual is rewarded accordingly.
Yeah. That's a double dribble as Jones was trying to make his move and slip. Timeout. 3:07 remaining. North Carolina with its largest lead of 6. That's right. Good evening. We're happy to have you with us here in College Park.
This is the eclipse I want.
Oh, yeah. My boy's finally getting himself a chick magnet.
Come on, man. 210 horsepower V6.
Oh, V6 chick magnet.
No. 3,500 cash.
ESPN2 on April 3rd. And what a way to start the season. Peter, you have covered the Reds.
Exactly.
We've got your back. Right now, get up to $3,500 combined cash on a new Eclipse. Mitsubishi, the best back cars in the world.
Is he with you?
No.
Oh.
If you need help with a criminal or DUI case, please remember Phillips and Associates.
When I was facing criminal charges, I needed an experienced, aggressive attorney that could help me. I made the right decision by hiring Phillips and Associates. My attorney did a great job, and I was very satisfied. If you need an experienced, aggressive attorney that can really help you, please call Phillips & Associates.
Little or no money down to begin your criminal or DUI case. Call us right now, 602-258-8888.
The best vehicle purchase experience we've ever had is a consistent compliment from completely satisfied customers at Thoroughbred Chevrolet. During Thoroughbred Chevrolet's Perfect Chevy Sale, over 1,200 new Chevys are all sale priced up to $1,000 below actual dealer invoice, plus take up to $4,000 more in factory rebates. Save up to $12,000 off the window sticker on 1,200 new Chevrolets. Don't miss Thoroughbred Chevrolet's Perfect Chevy Sale, only at Thoroughbred Chevrolet. Call 1-877-RIDE-CHEVY.
Pac-10 basketball on FSN. Washington goes for their first Pac-10 title in 20 years against Rod Benson and Cal. Pac-10 basketball, Thursday on FSN.
Coming up on the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show, I'll be joined by the coach Perry Clark, the vet Larry Conley. Who's the biggest and baddest of the Big 12? And in the wake of seeking a number one seed, Forrest is firing. It's the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show. Back out to College Park, Maryland. Check in with our trio of Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski, and Dwayne Ballin. Timmy B.
All right, Mike, North Carolina leading by six, just over 3 minutes remaining in the opening half. Our Elon first half stat of the game, field goal shooting percentage, and North Carolina, after a tough start with turnovers, they've really gotten their act together.
Well, on the year, Tim, on the year, North Carolina shooting 50% as a team. Astounding.
It is.
That, and then you look at field goal, number of field goals assisted, and that stat, I think, are an indication of how good your point guard play is. And Raymond Felton has just been outstanding. And a lot of that you can lay at his doorstep. You've got to have finishers, but he really sets the table.
Sean May has it knocked out of bounds on the double team. He's back on the floor. Brennan is also on the deck for Maryland. Michael Brennan. There he is, checking Terry. Painter Medley, Gilchrist, who, by the way, just scored his 1,000th career point a few moments ago. Maryland's in the midst of quite a drought.
Very active defensive stand by Maryland.
With two on the shot clock, Felton can't hit, needed to get it on the lid. And the foul against Marvin Williams.
And that was a great defensive sequence for Maryland. They really had North Carolina pushed out on the floor, and at the end of the clock, they forced a bad long three by Raymond Felton instead of letting him get into the paint.
That's the second foul on Marvin Williams, and the seventh team foul for North Carolina. So now they're in the 1-1.
Marvin Williams playing through turf toe, which he suffered against UConn. And believe me, I've had that injury. It stays with you. That does not go away quickly.
By the way, speaking of that, we were discussing with Roy Williams earlier today, Jawad Williams coming back onto the floor, the situation with McCants. And he said, he complained a little bit, even after the Duke game, going all the way back to early February. They played at UConn. Was a little bit indifferent at that point in time. Played for 34 minutes against Virginia, and then after that, disorder became even more difficult. He's not been able to eat, hold anything down in the last few weeks.
So this is more a thing of energy being an issue. I mean, he can't even go through a whole practice, let alone play, and it doesn't sound like it's anything that's going to come back quickly.
Yeah. That tip in by Manuel makes it 40-34. Gilchrist to McCray. One and done for the most part. North Carolina really blocking out the last few minutes. Carey, pass Brennan, gives it up to May.
Nice interior passing. Sean May does a nice job inside. We talked about his ability to catch. He made himself available as a receiver on the drive.
Gary Williams is livid with the lack of defensive help.
Here's the look inside, and see that drive? Sean May able to make up a lot of room without even putting the ball on the floor.
May has 12 points and 6 rebounds. And you see the numbers, Mike, inside the painted area. North Carolina doubling up on Maryland.
Felton really doing a nice job of feeding and fanning the big people.
That's incredible. You think about the players who have played there in the history of the program. Only 12 players in Carolina history have averaged a double-double, and that's what Sean May's trying to finish up right now.
McCray for three. He has been the constant, hasn't he?
And even with Manuel, Manuel's the fireman. Whoever's hot, that's who they sent him on. And that was just almost unguardable. It was so far out.
Poor pass by Noel. Leads to a turnover. McCray. Well, the rim got in the way that time as he tried to go finger roll.
Tim, fundamentally, you've got to come in from the side and use the backboard. How many times do you see a player trying to go right over the front and leave it up short?
Just all night long.
Jawad,
find the spot, move to it, and he is absolutely going to convert.
12 in the game for Jawad Williams.
And he's a guy who's really expanded his three-point game. He can knock down the jump shot, also very reliable in the post. Tough to guard.
Harrison can't hit. Manuel pulls it down. North Carolina beginning to extend. It looks remarkably similar to that first game in Chapel Hill.
They went on that run to close it out, and not quite as bad here. And Maryland certainly within distance, only 8 points.
You just get a feeling that the Tar Heels are not having to work nearly as hard to score as Maryland. Nice defensive play again by McCray. Out of bounds off him. Tar Heels will trigger it in.
You see the two-man game right here. You see Felton coming off and then the flare out on the jump shot. It's just tough to recover to defensively. Jawad Williams goes so far wide that the rotation can't get to him.
Well, the Tar Heels commit their seventh turnover, but only their second, really, in the last 12 minutes. They had five very quick turnovers.
And that's one you can live with. It goes out of bounds. You get a chance to set your defense on the other end. It's one of those turnovers that lead directly to points that kill you, those that take place out front.
Gilchrist wants it. Off the back iron, McCray trying to save it. It's pulled away by Manuel. Length of the floor, Noel. Boy, remember that. And again, the floor not balanced. And Gary Williams very upset that his team was not balanced along the floor defensively.
Just the pace of the play grinds you down for North Carolina. And again, here where turnovers kill you when they happen out front like this. Nobody back in rotation. David Noel puts a punctuation mark on the first half for the Tar Heels.
A 21-8 run to close out the half. Let's go in the corridor to Dwayne Ballard. Dwayne?
Senior night and your team came out, withstood that impressive first half.
Well, we got to do a better job getting back in defensive transition, and we can't give them so many free throws. To me, they seem like they stayed on the free throw line and didn't miss very many of them, Dwayne.
Finally, defensively, you've held them under 40% from the floor.
The last three or four minutes, we played much better job defensively.
Thank you, Coach. Let's send it to the studio and Mike Oberg.
Dwayne, thank you very much. So the number two team in the nation leads by 10. Welcome to the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show. Alongside the coach Perry Clark, the vet Larry Conley, I'm Mike Goldberg. For number two North Carolina coach, Rashad McCants or not, the defense is always omnipresent.
Without question, I think that's one of the biggest things Roy Williams has brought to this club this year defensively. In the last 3 minutes, I thought they did a great job of taking Maryland out of what they wanted to run and extending them in their offense.
Yeah, Gary Williams should be upset with his club. You don't allow a team like that to run out, particularly right at the end of the first half. Chris McCray had a great first half, though, 13
Chris
points.
McCray establishing himself, but will it be in back-to-back losses? That is the big concern. Coming up on the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show, does Big 12 supremacy still live in Lawrence? A top 10 tilt and much more next on the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show.
Embrace the spotlight. Greatness won't come to you. You have to reach for it. Bass, reach for greatness.
A search engine that delivers unbiased health information so people can make informed decisions. A physician finder that enables them to locate the right doctor for the problem. Just some of the features that make WebMD America's most trusted and most visited health site. A site that's recommended by more physicians and relied on by more than 20 million Americans every month. WebMD, America's health site.
Take the dollar.
What's going on, man?
It won't take my dollar. Wow, that looks good.
Oh, yeah, it's new from KFC. Real chicken breast. Only a dollar.
You got that for a dollar?
Yeah. I took your dollar.
Oh.
Ready for a tasty bargain? Try the brand new 99-cent snacker from KFC. 100% hand-flowered chicken breast, pepper mayo, and crisp lettuce freshly prepared on a sesame seed bun. Now your dollar goes further at KFC.
I mean, I used to date these guys, and I wonder, why doesn't this feel right? You know, why isn't he the one? And then I met Ben. You know, it's really nice when you realize you don't have to compromise. I mean, that's why I bought a Saturn.
140 horsepower, 35 miles per gallon highway. The no-compromise 2005 Saturn Ion. Lease a new 2005 Saturn Ion 1 for $139 a month. Residency restrictions apply. Call for details.
Well, it's been a pleasure, Craig.
You're leaving us?
Yes, I'm going to be working at Anderson's just up the street.
Anderson's? That's a shame.
Turn your back on us, would you? After all we've done for you.
The rules of the London underworld. Learn to live by them. Rated M for mature.
The bigger the stage, the bigger the opportunity. Greatness won't come to you. You have to reach for it. Bass, reach for greatness.
The human toll of the tsunami disaster has affected all of us.
And we can all do something to help. Please visit usafreedomcorps.gov. Thank you.
ACC Sunday Night Hoops is presented by Staples. That was easy. And brought to you in part by Bass. Reach for greatness.
Great matchup in the Big 12. Number 4, Oklahoma State at number 8, Kansas. John Lucas had quite a game.
Mikey, did he hit his first 9 shots of the evening and had a terrific game, but it wasn't enough.
It was not. Look at this finish. Aaron Miles keeps it himself, hits the layup. 2-point lead, Jayhawks, and then Lucas one more time to try to win it. Won't happen. Eddie Sutton is the Oklahoma State head coach. 0-11. At Fog Allen Fieldhouse. Elsewhere, Nebraska, a big win, also in the Big 12. They moved to 13-12. Iowa State is on the bubble. Curtis Stinson held to just 9 points in the contest. In the ACC, Virginia at number 6, Wake Forest. Chris Paul early, Chris Paul in the middle, Chris Paul late.
It was the Chris Paul show. Not only did he score, but he got other people involved. Williams had 17, Justin Gray had 20.
A very balanced attack for Skip Prosser's team. Wake, a half game back of North Carolina. This week they host Georgia Tech, then they are at NC State. They win big time. And Florida State loses for the 8th straight time. Clemson gets consecutive wins for the first time since mid-December. Clemson wins 83-74. They host Virginia Tech on Tuesday night. All right, let's stay in the ACC, Coach and Vet. Let's talk about number 6, Wake Forest. Still very much in line for a number 1 seed in the NCAA tournament, and still, Larry, very much in line for an ACC title.
Mike, I agree. You know, they've got Tech at home, and of course they go to North Carolina State for that game next weekend. And as we look at the three clubs that are at the top right now, North Carolina, Duke, and Wake Forest, I really think, Perry, the schedule really favors North Carolina. They've got 2 left, both of them at home.
Yeah, but Larry, they have to beat Duke for one of them, but I do think that the Wake Forest Georgia Tech game has huge implications in the ACC.
Well, it is always fun as we get to this time of year, everybody trying to get that crown jewel, and the first one is the ACC regular season title. Jawad Williams doing his part in the first half for number 2 North Carolina. A dozen points, UNC leads by 10.
Howdy, folks. Since 1951, the Earnhardt family's been selling cars and trucks. Although times have changed, what has never changed is the Earnhardt commitment to world-class service and low prices that can't be beat.
At Earnhardt Ford in Tempe, you can buy a new 05 Ford and get 0% financing for up to 60 months or discounts up to $10,200. That's Earnhardt Ford at Baseline and Rural in Tempe.
The Earnhardt name is a name you can trust, folks. That's a commitment from our family to yours. That's Earnhardt. No bull since 1951.
Let Empire Glass replace your cracked windshield, and we'll pay up to $100 of your comprehensive insurance deductible. And we'll now give you 24 free dinners to Chewy's Mesquite Broiler with any windshield replacement. So for the highest quality windshields, including up to $100 off your comprehensive insurance deductible and 24 free dinners to Chewy's Mesquite Broiler, call Empire Glass today at 602-952-9339. And when you think glass, think Empire.
There are moments when time stands still, when history unfolds, when we are bound by the magnificence of one singular event, memories that forever echo through time, immortal accomplishments by mortal men. This is where dreamers become legends. Fox Sports Net, Arizona. The moments are waiting.
Just stick with me, kid. I know this town like the back of my hand. Hey, that's new.
From the creators of Ice Age, they're well-built.
Oh, dear.
I'll get them.
Oh, look at that. Oh, now they're arm wrestling.
Well-maintained.
This is my third oil change today. Something's wrong with me.
And they're fighting back.
We're here to save you!
How do you think it's going so far?
Robots.
Who are these losers?
We, sir.
I'm a woman. Ouch.
Rated PG. March 11th, only in theaters.
The Wildcat Insider, Friday at 6:30 and 10 on FSN Arizona.
Welcome back to the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show. Maryland winners of six of their last seven games against North Carolina at home. They trail the number two team in the nation by 10 at the break. Next week on ACC Sunday Night Hoops, number six Wake Forest at NC State. Tip-off set for 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific. More in a moment on the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show.
At your Valley Lexus dealer.
This April, Phoenix International Raceway brings you NASCAR in a whole new light. PIR's first Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night NASCAR weekend will only heat up when the sun goes down. So get your tickets now. Watch the NASCAR Busch Series and NASCAR Nextel Cup Series racers start their battles at twilight and finish under the lights April 21st through 23rd at PIR. Call 1-866-408-RACE for the best seats available or log on to phoenixraceway.com. It's NASCAR in a whole new light.
Just announced.
And for a limited time only, $199 a month or $0 down gets you into a quality pre-owned vehicle from Bill Mazda and Imports.
Any car, any truck, any van, any SUV, any vehicle on the lot.
Drive one away today for only $199 a month or $0 down.
Your choice.
Choose from over 6 million in on-hand inventory and only $199 a month or zero down. No gimmicks, just great deals. Bidolf Mazda and Imports, 8424 West Bell Road in Peoria. One block west of 101 Loop on Bell Road.
Spring training is in full swing on FSN Arizona. This week, kick off the Cactus League with Barry Zito of the new look Oakland A's. Plus, it can be a long road to the starting rotation. Sean Estes reveals how he maximized his opportunities in spring training. Then, party like a VIP as the Best Damn Sports Show period's Leanne Tweet slips you past the velvet rope at the hottest night spots in Arizona. Inside the Cactus League premieres tonight at 10 on FSN Arizona.
Pac-10 Tournament returns in March. An automatic bid to the Big Dance is on the line as the men's tourney returns to Staples Center. While the women do battle at HP Pavilion in San Jose, this is your chance to be a part of the madness. For tickets, log on to www.pac-10.org.
The Arizona Sports Report, nightly on Fox Sportsnet.
Welcome back to the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show. Chris McCray once again having his way. 16 points, 4 of 4 from beyond the arc in the first half. Terrapins trail by 10. To the Big East, number 23, Villanova at Georgetown. The freshman, Kyle Lowry, the lefty, had a strong afternoon.
Villanova's playing extremely well. They had four people in double figures. A tough loss for Georgetown at home in Hunts for an NCAA bid.
Villanova has not been to the dance since 1999. In the Big Ten, number 20, Wisconsin wins 64-56, but Indiana upsets Michigan State in overtime.
Let me see. Yep, there's still a pulse. Indiana's still alive.
All right, let's talk our game. Number 2, North Carolina and Maryland, second half forthcoming. Perry Clark, how does Maryland get themselves back in this game?
I think that they have to offensively. I think they have to execute a little bit better than what they're doing, and they cannot give North Carolina a lot of runouts.
Tar Heels are ready to put them away. Yeah. Just put the nail in the coffin right now.
You got that RPI still on your mind. I know that. David Noel certainly thinks that it's Christmas time, and it's a joy to be playing in Carolina Blue right now. Carolina leads by 10, as this has been the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show.
Howdy, folks. Since 1951, the Earnhardt family's been selling cars and trucks. Although times have changed, what has never changed is the Earnhardt commitment to world-class service and low prices that can't be beat.
At Earnhardt Dodge, you can buy a new Dodge for just 1 cent under factory invoice. Plus, you keep the rebates up to $5,500. This is an exclusive offer only at Earnhardt Dodge on Country Club south of Baseline in Gilbert.
The Earnhardt name is a name you can trust, folks. That's a commitment from our family to yours. That's Earnhardt. No bull since 1951.
Come on. Come on. This is taking forever. Look at that guy. He thinks he's Nash. This is ridiculous. Watch.
Sorry.
That's right. Everyone stops for the ball.
The fastest and strongest to the most capable and most powerful Dodge Ram trucks. Matched by none, envied by all.
Come on, man, floor it!
Grab 0+, 0% financing plus package discounts plus February bonus cash for total savings up to $9,000.
A symptom checker that allows people to isolate the warning signs of an illness and understand what they mean. Assessment tools that summarize risks and treatment options to discuss with their physicians. Just some of the features that make WebMD America's most trusted and most visited health site. Recommended by more physicians and relied on by more than 20 million Americans every month. WebMD, America's health site.
This week on the Best Damn Sports Show, period. Red Sox pitcher David Wells, former Sixers owner Pat Croce, and comedian Paul Rodriguez. This week at 10:30.
ACC Sunday Night Hoops is presented by Staples. That was easy. And brought to you in part by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge. Our score at halftime, 47. I believe you can see it right there. 47-37. Tim Brando, Mike Kaminsky, Dwayne Dallin, happy to have you with us. And for Gary Williams, the plight, very similar to the last time these two teams met. It was 47-34 in Chapel Hill.
Right, and it's the same script, too. The first 13 minutes or so, Maryland was very competitive. And see here that John Gilchrist, their point guard, got him off early. He had 8 points in the first 20 minutes. But the big story for Maryland, Chris McCray, 16 points, perfect. 4 of 4 from behind the arc. However, the last 7 minutes, North Carolina goes on a run. Jawad Williams spreading the defense down, knocks down that jump shot. He has 12 points. Raymond Felton, the look ahead. David Noel with the finish at the half, and it is a 10-point spread. And the number right there, you can't let a team come into your building and shoot 52%. Yeah, yeah. You know, Carolina is Carolina, but you know they've got to be more disruptive defensively.
Your Elon halftime stats and the number of bench points for North Carolina, that's not uncommon, but the points in the paint just really jump out at you. Sean May and Jawad Williams had their way. 24 points between them. And were it not for the play of Chris McCray, 16 points, 4 of 4 from downtown, Maryland would be in a world of hurt going into the second half. That's a walk by North Carolina. Look at the rest of the team versus what McCray has done.
Well, and the guy they're really missing is Travis Garrison. He, over his last four games, averaging 16 points and 8 rebounds per attempt. He did not score in the first half and only 2 rebounds. They need him to step up.
Perhaps that man, too, Kaner Medley, just the follow. Just gives them an extra athletic body in the painted area.
Well, and remember, too, that they played a lot of the first half with Mike Grennan on the floor, a guy who doesn't get a lot of big minutes. I mean, it's a senior night. You're not going to take that away from him, but, you know, you're out of your normal rhythm.
Right past Kaner Medley. Failed to finish, but there's Sean May on the block. And the reach-in foul will go against Maryland. moment ago, Dwayne Ballon talked with Gary Williams, right, Dwayne?
Yeah, I did, Tim, and Gary was pretty intense in the locker room, and I asked him about defensive intensity, and he was very pointed with me. He said, listen, my team is playing very hard. You make sure that you point that out. My guys are playing hard. We do need to finish some plays. We haven't gotten all the calls we wanted, but my guys are playing hard, and he didn't want to hear anything about them lacking in intensity. It was interesting how serious he was about that.
Yeah, and I can understand that. He's been, you know, on them all week about giving him effort on the defensive end of the floor. I don't know that the breakdown at the end of the half had anything to do with effort, but clearly he didn't like the fact that Noel had an easy slam to close out the half because the floor was not balanced.
And where the turnover takes place, and just you're talking about the number two team in the country, and your margin for error against them is very minimal.
Scott got the foul. That's his second. Team's first foul of the second half. Garrison, that's a reach-in foul against May.
See, that's exactly what Travis Garrison needs to do. You need to put pressure on Sean May, make him defend you. Now, Garrison is not a low-post player, but he does have the ability, Tim, to put the ball on the floor, and he drew contact and the foul on the play.
Second on the team, Travis Garrison.
Garrison, one of those players that they just know they can get more from. He's more of a face-up player. I think a lot of people wanted to make him a post-up variety, similar to that of a Jamar Smith, and that's just not his game. It's one of the two, and it's 49-40. Gist is now checking Jawad Williams. Certainly had his way from the perimeter. Manuel blowing by Kaner Medley, but it's fouled on the deck. It'll go against Nick Kaner Medley.
We talk all year about Jackie Manuel not needing the ball to perform well, and he is known as a primary defender. But I think in this instance, trying to put some pressure on Kaner Medley, make him defend and get him in foul trouble. He's been very active looking for his own drive here in the first minute and a half.
Jackie Manuel, I think, understands with Rashad McCants not available that he's got to be a bit more assertive on the offensive end of the floor. In fact, I believe all the Heels seem to be playing that way. That's a goaltending that where it really was not needed. We're not even sure that ball would have gotten off of the front iron.
That's just a freshman being a little over-aggressive. And you know what? You can't scold him if you're Gary Williams. You know, it's a bad judgment play, but at least his motor's running, Tim. And that's, again, talking about the effort that Gary Williams talked about at halftime.
Kaner Medley, a drive. Williams rips it out of there.
Very few second chance opportunities for Maryland.
Rod Williams sets the pick. Felton takes advantage. Off the front iron, Gist pulls it down, and he's fouled by Manuel. That's number two on Jackie. Bickway comes into the game now for the Terrapins, and Garrison sits down. We talk so often, Mike, about how important the first 5 minutes and the last 5 minutes of the half may be. North Carolina clearly won the last 5 minutes of the first half. Very important that Maryland answer here. Kaner Medley with a trade. 51-43.
It's still basically, it's McCray, Gilchrist, and Kaner Medley doing all of the scoring for Maryland right now. Nobody else has stepped up, but they needed that three.
May over a big way. Failed to finish. I believe he lost it on the way up.
The ball slipped out of his hands. He just has a decided strength advantage against the Beckway.
No luck inside to a Beckway from Gilchrist.
Little lapse as Sean May was lost coming back defensively. You had to identify where your man is, and if there is an advantage that a Beckway has, it's speed up and down the floor.
Felton. Manuel on the offensive glass. Ball's on the deck. Jawad Williams with the garbage deuce. Every loose ball down low, the Tar Heels front line gets. Abekwe. Not there. disturbed mightily by May. And again, open dunk on the other end of the floor.
And that's what a bad shot gets you to. When you surprise your teammates like that, there's no defensive balance at all, and just an easy breakout for North Carolina.
Wide with 16, and just like that, North Carolina's lead back to 10. And Jerry Williams wants a timeout.
The Terrapins call timeout.
We talked a little bit about that with Gary Williams earlier today. Those loose ball situations. Jawad Williams sprinting for the slam.
Wow. Oh, somebody's got to do this.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go, Matt. Not that far, Matt. You got this.
Oh. Wow, you really stuck that landing.
Shut it.
Go new places, experience new things. Forerunner, now that's moving you forward.
Hey, Teddy, can you come in here and do some rebates for me?
Sure.
Actually, sir, my biological dad, who I haven't seen in 20 years, just showed up. And he really wants to take me for ice cream, so...
Teddy.
Yeah?
You know we have an easy button now, right?
We have an easy button?
When it comes to rebates...
Larry. Dave.
Everybody has an easy button. It's called Staples. Just go online. There's no clipping, no mailing, no hassles. What's easier than that? Staples. That was easy.
We dribble up and down the court. I like slam dunks that take me to the hoop. My favorite play is the alley-oop.
Playing basketball.
Find scores, find tickets, find just what you're after with a new, more precise MSN search.
One of the most respected reporters is back and head-to-head with James Brown. JB visits with defending NASCAR champion Kurt Busch, examines the recent poker craze, all of that coming up on Head-to-Head tomorrow at 9. 55-45, there's the sign we were talking about. Pretend they're Duke, and especially now, 10-point lead again for North Carolina, 55-45. Going to take a look at that last play that you were talking about.
Well, you see right here, hold right here. You see Sean May. He's got the sight line on Ebekwe, who's behind him. But then as the play unfolds, he'll turn, and Ebekwe just outsprints him into the paint area. You see right there, a little bit of a lost vision. And Ebekwe, nice hustle, never giving up on the play. Good look inside, and that gets you 2 points. Nice to see him rewarded for running the floor.
Ebekwe, sophomore from Carson, California. Outstanding shot blocker. They need he and Gist to really provide a spark inside, because it has just been all North Carolina along the front line, and now both Jawad Williams and Sean May are out of the game.
We talked about it. It looked like Carolina was on the verge of really trying to break things open, Tim, and this is a very critical time for Maryland. Now with those players out, they've got a chance to narrow the gap.
Terry, Noel, and Marvin Williams are now on the floor for North Carolina. There's McCray with a steal. Painter Medley, a leaner, does not fall. Once again, Terry takes it down and gives it up.
Well, and North Carolina had numbers back. I think Painter Medley tried to force something that wasn't there.
Noel, very strong to the basket.
That's what hurts against North Carolina. You get a turnover, you have a chance to score, you miss that opportunity, and they turn it into 2 points.
Committed by Terry. 15:32 remaining here in the second half, and the Heels still hold a 10-point cushion.
Yeah. Ow. Yeah, that kind of burns a little.
A little help here. Oh.
I think someone's going to have to suck the poison out. Yeah. We better find somebody fast.
Go new places, experience new things. Forerunner, now that's moving you forward.
Step onto the field. Electrify the last row. take the ultimate ride. Shatter records. Start a movement. Greatness won't come to you. You have to reach for it. Bass, reach for greatness.
Mayday, mayday.
Gun runners,
what are you waiting for?
Target practice.
This Tuesday, they're in for the fight of their lives. Flight of the Phoenix, only on DVD Tuesday.
Come on!
All good things in time, my boy.
Haste makes waste.
Patience is a virtue.
Your day will come.
Now, luxurious things can come to those who'd rather not wait. The Acura Certified Pre-Owned Vehicle Program.
North Carolina by 10 here on Oscar Night. We're celebrating ourselves here on ACC Sunday Night Hoops with a Foxy. How about the play of the year? Xavien Dowdell's winning shot against Duke. And, of course, they held off the Dukies in one of many very big wins for Seth Greenberg, who certainly is a strong candidate for Coach of the Year. And you look at the standings in the ACC, Virginia Tech right there at 7-7 with an opportunity to play their way in. I think their biggest issue is overall team losses. They need to get as many W's as possible.
And RPI well over 100, yes, too, which is going to set them back. But, Tim, that sets up they are at Clemson on Tuesday, and that sets up a huge game with Maryland going to Virginia Tech to finish out the year.
Particularly if this score holds up.
Yep.
Terps is trying to get to 8-8 and managed to get into the NCAA tournament. Those RPIs, I think, may mean less this year than they have in the past. But the truth of the matter is, if you're inside 50, you feel pretty good. If you're outside it, you're struggling.
Yeah, Georgia Tech kind of right on that line, although they had a huge win down in Miami.
Came from behind in the second half to get it done. Loose ball, out of bounds. It will belong to the Terps. Gilchrist with only one field goal, one assist in the last 21 minutes. He was outstanding early. Yes, in traffic, stays with it over Marvin Williams.
Right, two talented freshmen going at it athletically down in the post, and Gist was just quicker off the floor on three occasions.
Marvin Williams only has 2 points tonight, and with this lineup, he needs to become more active. Is guilty of taking an extra step there. Sean May will quickly re-enter the game for North Carolina.
Well, with the lineup as it was out on the floor, Maryland could really collapse on Marvin Williams, and that's what the issue was. Now, with Sean May, they've got to pay attention to him.
In a game that featured a high wire act the first 15 minutes, North Carolina ended with a strong 21-8 run at the close of the first half. To get a 10-point lead, they've maintained that through the early moments of the second half. North Carolina with a lead by 8. Kiss the rebound. Manuel can't come up with it. Gilchrist alley-ooping for Gist inside.
Well, once again, Maryland's bigs beating North Carolina down the floor. How about Gist? He gets the rebound defensively and then outsprints everybody for the layup.
He has 8. Marvin Williams, another freshman, trying to return to sender. And with the ball fake, he's able to get a Pekwe airborne, and he picks up the foul.
Here's the look, and it just, I think, Gist's ability to catch the ball. That was a tough catch going away from the play. He was running out of real estate on the play. One of those long sideline jump shots can get you into trouble and spread you out.
And the speed down the floor was also impressive for the freshman.
Well, he and Abekwe have both made plays like that in this half.
Jones coming back on the floor. Mike Jones, the sophomore from Massachusetts. They need some offensive punch from the perimeter, and he can deliver that. Abekwe sits down. Kenny has picked up a number of fouls early on. He's got three and six with 14-14 remaining in the game. And Marvin Williams just plays within himself. I mean, this is a star talent that has really adopted the team concept. And tonight, it's all about Jawad Williams and really, to some extent, Noel. Noel's come in and really delivered on both ends of the floor.
Quality bench points, rebounds, assists. Nice stat line for him in this game.
Gaynor Medley lost the dribble. Fortunate that Jones came up with it. Yes, a little duck under against May, and Sean won that duel. Noel leaves it to Manuel.
Boy, what a nice break. That was a great decision by David Noel. Gave Manuel a second count to get in position to receive the pass.
And again, Gary Williams calls a timeout and some of those shock treatment defensive transition TOs he's taken.
Here's the break without Raymond Felton involved in it. Just nice feel for the basketball. The dribble to let Kaner Medley go flying by. That break is such a lethal weapon for North Carolina.
13 transition points. When you think about the outstanding newcomer that Marvin Williams is and how much depth and talent Roy has on his floor, there's no question about that. But they've not had one ACC Player of the Week. We asked Roy Williams about it.
It is flattering in some ways because we do talk so much about team, but I'm also one of those guys that always says that the teams that win, their players get the awards and rewards. And so it is a little unusual with that because we've had some pretty good performances. And it's directly in contrast to hear all those people say they've got the best talent in America, but we've never had anybody talented enough to be the Player of the Week.
It is an outstanding point. And to be honest with you, I was surprised when told that that was in fact the case after looking at it. McCray comes in and quickly gets the deuce. He's carried this team offensively. He has 18.
Well, you know, how many times is it that the great coaches, or considered great coaches, never get Coach of the Year?
Yeah.
You know, there's always a better story. I mean, Seth Greenberg may get it this year, and, you know, and here Roy Williams probably going to run the table and win the conference.
May over Gist, count it, and the foul. See where the Tar Heels have always ranked in the NCAA annals and points per game, scoring margin. I'd say that's good coaching, wouldn't you?
But you know what, Tim? That rarely translates into national championships. And that's the slope. You know, it's been a long time since the leading scoring team in the nation has won it all. But I think the difference for this team is they're defending so much better than they did last year.
And by the way, we all know that's the one thing missing on Roy Williams' resume. Jones rejected by May.
By Sean May, just quietly taking control of this game.
And Noel is fouled inside.
Here's the look. Mike Jones, to his credit, trying to make something happen, and he has to go not only past Noel, who probably set up that block for Sean May. May comes in and cleans it up and gets the double dip on the stat line with the block and the rebound.
Jones got the foul for Maryland. And again, the lead is still 10. And with the pace of the game, you really begin to think that Maryland is fortunate that it's only 10. Gist, a face-up shot over May, not there.
Right, you know, John Gilchrist is trying to get his team involved, but you sense that he's going to start looking for his own shot pretty soon.
North Carolina in firm control of this one. They have been since late in the first half. Still maintain a 10-point lead with 12 and a half remaining. Raymond Felton picks up that foul, and it'll go the other way. Tim Brando alongside Mike Jaminski and Wayne Ballin roaming the sidelines for us. ECC Sunday Night Hoops presented by Staples. McCray searching for the foul, and he gets it from Manuel.
Well, and you will see one of the best free throw shooters in the nation now step up to the line. That's the thing I like for, you know, you look at McCray, he only averages 3 free throw attempts a game.
Well, I believe we're going to have the officials take a look at the monitor to see if, in fact, that was a 3-point attempt by McCray rather than a 2-point attempt, which is what Ray Natilli rule.
And the reason why, because McCray was really jumping forward on that play, and it's your takeoff point.
I think he may need a different angle besides that one.
It looked like his right toe was over the line, but tough to see through the stanchion.
And this will be a difficult angle as well. And again, they've got to be able to see something a lot more defining than that.
Yeah, that's a two.
That's a two. He's inside.
Right foot just over the line.
That's the one you want right there. It was a good call. It's a two-shot violation. And by the way, without the duck under, he doesn't get the foul. He clearly was looking for the shot and the foul.
Right, and Manuel doesn't usually make that type of mistake where he goes flying up, that McCray put a nice head fake on him and got him off his feet.
Junior from Capitol Heights, Maryland, Chris McCray. Chris has a cousin, Charlie Bell, who's a freshman playing at Loyola of Maryland. And so it's been in the family. They got the basketball mix going on. He gets both.
94% from the line. As I say, you like to see him in a position, maybe gets into the low block, posts up, and uses those moves to get himself to the free throw line a little more frequently. That being said, 20 points on the evening.
Travis Garrison commits the foul. And the thing about McCray you have to love is when you talk to him or you read what he has to say in newspapers and periodicals about the Maryland situation, he's quick to point out that Gary Williams is absolutely right. They've got the mesh as a team. Foul spotted underneath. And Gary Williams is beside himself. Goes against Jones, it appears. His second. It was a push against Juwan Williams.
And that's the frustrating thing, again, if you're Maryland, you've been making these little runs, and they get bailed out with a miss on the one-on-one. But they'll make a play and get it down to six, and then that lead will expand back up to 10.
Jones for three. He was a highly heralded high school talent, largely because of just that, an outstanding offensive player.
Well, it was the swing of the basketball that set him up too, Tim, and Sean May a little reluctant to come out and get a hand up on him. That's the best look that Jones has had this evening.
Williams. Jones trying to keep it alive and does. Look at May on the deck. Boy, the effort from the big fella. Outstanding. Roy Williams disagrees with Ray Natilli's call, and Maryland's got it.
Sterling Ledbetter. Put some skin on the floor.
May puts it on the deck. And the Terps will have it when we come back.
Tender crisp bacon cheddar ranch, the breasts they grow on trees, and streams of bacon ranch dressing flow right up to your knees. There's tumbleweeds of bacon and cheddar paves the streets. You get the veg all day, all the lotto tickets pay. There's a king who wants you to have it your way. That's the tender crisp bacon cheddar ranch, the tender crisp bacon cheddar ranch.
Come and get it.
From the minute my son was born, I knew I wanted to be that dad. The guy who can show you how to throw a perfect spiral, fixing bikes and skateboard ramps, going to ball games. My father was that dad, and now I've become that dad. That's why I bought a Saturn.
The all-new 7-passenger 2005 Saturn Relay, with the security of OnStar and DVD player standard. Lease a new 2005 Saturn Relay front-wheel drive 2 for $299 a month. Residency restrictions apply. Call for details.
Later this year, we're launching the first of several new satellites that together will deliver over 1,500 high-definition channels across the country. It's part of DirecTV's commitment to the best TV experience. Your TV's ready. Are you?
Check out the Endeavor.
Ooh, but should we?
These are the best backed cars in the world, and it's
one of the top-ranked SUVs around.
Well, maybe.
It is the perfect fit for that family we've been talking about.
Oh, honey.
Mitsubishi's got your back with up to $5,500 in combined cash on select vehicles. Hurry. Offer ends soon.
It seats five.
North Carolina leads Maryland 63-58 here on ACC Sunday Night Hoops. In 1965-66 season, history was made in the ACC when Billy Jones joined the Maryland Terrapins. He became the first African-American player in the history of the ACC in basketball. He is here tonight as an honorary captain of the Terrapins. Mr. Jones, can you begin to tell us what it was like for you in that historic season?
Well, it was a case where basketball is important to me, and much like high school, you're doing things that haven't been done before, and it was challenging. But Gary Williams, Gary Ward, Joe Harrington made life very easy for me, and it was a great season. I'm glad I did what we did.
Well, your Terrapins are responding right now. You mentioned that Gary Williams was your teammate.
Yes.
What did it mean to have teammates like him that would stick by you?
Gary, and again, it's nice to know people have your back. Gary was always there. He's still there. He grabbed me tonight, got me on the bench. I told my wife I would not sit on the bench this year, but Gary got me to sit on the bench. And we're going to get this thing yet.
Thank you. Billy Jones, the first African-American player in the history of the ACC. Guys?
All right, that's great to hear from him. And there's always been a tremendous amount of history surrounding the ACC here at Maryland. And there's McCray. The 8-0 run ended when Juwan Williams hit the shot, but the Terrapins clearly making their move.
Now, Mike Jones coming in, giving a big lift off of the bench, and nice curl play. They've got to respect McCray's jump shooting ability, and that allowed him to curl around the screen and get the layup.
Inside they go to May, and Garrison once again will pick up the foul.
There's a look inside, just an easy catch for Sean May. If you can get it with 2 feet in the paint, normally you're going to finish.
Maryland making a strong move with an 8-0 run as clawed to within two of the second-ranked Tar Heels. Just over 10 minutes remaining. Williams. Marvin Williams trying to corral it. Out of bounds, last touch by Jack Emanuel. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski, Dwayne Ballin here in College Park, Maryland. The Terrapins trying to solidify an NCAA bid with a victory against the mighty Tar Heels. Ledbetter, a runner. Count it, and we are tied. The last tie was at 26. With plenty of time remaining in the first half.
The bench was not a factor for Maryland in the first half. They've come to play here in the second half. Sterling Ledbetter, I just don't know. Raymond Felton, lack of respect or whatever, lost him completely on that play.
Jones rejected that shot by Scott. Jones and Gist have given a lot of energy, Mike, to the Maryland Terrapins in the second half. One freshman and a sophomore. Felton comes up empty. Manuel trying to save it. Out of bounds to the Terrapins. And Roy Williams still a little concerned about Jack Emanuel.
Well, that was a tough shot. There's still time left on the clock. Felton trying to elevate his team offensively.
North Carolina in control much of this ACC season. Kaner Medley too strong. Felton with a quick outlet. Melvin Scott going deep. Tries to save it. Out of bounds. Last touch by Raymond Felton, and Maryland's got it.
There's some questionable decisions by North Carolina with the basketball over this last stretch. They have not been very efficient on the offensive end.
David Noel coming on the floor. Crowd responds to the play of Ledbetter as Gilchrist comes back up. The turnover story. North Carolina uncharacteristically turning it over the last few times down. Garrison over Williams. Loose ball. Marvin Williams pulls it down.
Right, it has just not been there offensively for Travis Garrison in this game. He and Ebekwe both have really struggled.
Whereas Gist and Jones have been difference makers. Noel with the dump down to Marvin Williams. He's fouled from the back by Jones.
Well, and an unnecessary foul. I thought that Travis Garrison had Marvin Williams under control defensively. It would have been a tough shot for him to make. If you're Mike Jones, you just got to find your guy and block him out or get on the board yourself.
That's three on Mike Jones. North Carolina, conventional wisdom is they are the strongest other than Illinois in holding on to a number one seed for the NCAA tournament. But this is really more about, when you think about it for them, Mike, this is about flexing your muscles at this time of the year. You see what Marvin Williams has done as a freshman, clearly the freshman of the year in this league, one would think. But this is more about where you are in the conference and maintaining a level of play going into the ACC tournament.
Well, I think more importantly, too, Roy Williams wants to see his team respond to its last true road game.
That's right.
Of the year. You know, good test going in. I mean, they will play in the ACC tournament, but everything going on is going to be neutral, and they finish up with two at home.
Felton with numbers. Scott for three. Outstanding decision-making by the Tar Heels in that fast break sequence.
Right, there's no doubt that this team will make the extra pass when necessary. And they saw that Scott was open, trusted him. He had had a tough offensive night up to that.
30-second timeout with 7:58 remaining. And don't forget, it only gets better as we get closer to the finish of ACC Sunday Night Hoops. During the regular season, how about another team trying to maintain its hold on a possible number one seeding? Wake Forest taking on North Carolina State at the RBC Center, 8 o'clock Eastern time, so note the time, a bit later than tonight, and 7 o'clock Central, 5 Pacific time.
Well, at North Carolina State, and you see Maryland, actually, they've won the last three meetings at home against North Carolina. But for NC State, look ahead. They've got a critical game coming up at Virginia. They're sitting at 6-8. I think they've got to run the table to have a legitimate chance. And the road, not easy for them, because Wake has got plenty to play for in that game as well.
This is a time in the game when you really begin to understand matchups and what they can mean. And for the most part, with Ledbetter on the floor, along with Jones and clearly James Gist, Maryland played better basketball. And for the moment, Gilchrist is back out there, along with Jones, but Travis Garrison remains. McCray has been the constant throughout the game. Jones again. He is lighting it up.
Against a pretty good defensive player, too, and David Noel, who is right in his shirt.
3-for-4 from downtown for him. Manuel gives it up. Noel rattles it home.
Gets it back. Gets that three back. He is the second one of the game.
Just that quickly, Gary Williams has James Gist ready to get back on the deck. Garrison working it on Williams. Again, his defense just too steady down there. Manuel outlet to Jawad Williams. That's an offensive. Well, they're going to call steps instead.
Timeout. 7:14 remaining. Mr. Jones, your neighborhood is downtown tonight. More to come from College Park as Maryland makes its move on number 2, North Carolina.
Embrace the spotlight. Greatness won't come to you. You have to reach for it. Bass, reach for greatness.
Six-speed, 270-horsepower Acura TL adjusts to the way each individual accelerates, brakes, and takes on the curves. Because no two drivers are alike. The Acura TL, a higher form of performance.
Thanks to our 555 deal, that's three pizzas for just $5 each, everyone can get exactly what they want. It's changing the way people order pizza.
Three pizzas with whatever I want. If I want olive, I can order olive. If I want pineapple, I can order pineapple.
But you order three pepperoni.
I fear change.
Domino's 555 deal is back. Buy three or more medium one-topping pizzas and they're all just $5 each. Get the door, it's the 555 deal.
The bigger the stage, the bigger the opportunity. Greatness won't come to you. You have to reach for it. Bass, reach for greatness.
This week on the Bass Amp Sports Show, period. Former Philadelphia 76ers owner Pat Croce, how he feels about Chris Webber joining the Sixers, and how will Allen Iverson and C. Webb get along? Plus, comedian Paul Rodriguez, how his son is making a name for himself in the extreme world, and newly acquired Red Sox pitcher David Wells. Will his remarks about A-Rod boost the rivalry? This week at 10:30.
Get your poker face on. Beginning March 13th, the world's best players will once again gather to finally answer the question, who's the greatest poker player in the world? Find out on Poker Superstars Invitational 2, beginning March 13th. Mike Jones has been incredible. 3 of 4 from downtown and has actually played some very good defense.
Well, there's the long skip pass that gets him his first open three, and that's the thing that really got him off. And then a shooter like that, once the spark is lit, he is seeing a big basket, 3 of 4 from behind the arc.
Loose ball, last touch by Jones, and North Carolina will have it. Those scrum situations, when they do occur, there's the line on Jones. 3 of 4 from downtown. North Carolina seems to win all of those. Traffic. That's another step situation as May took the jump stop a bit too far. Ledbetter back on the floor now. Gilchrist sits, and the way the second half has gone, Mike, I'm not surprised at all that Sterling Ledbetter's out there. Again, another loose ball situation played by North Carolina.
Well, and Gary Williams not afraid to ride the hot hand, and Ledbetter has just done a better job of running the ball club in the second half.
That's a kicked ball by Jones, a fresh 35 for North Carolina. And the other factor here for John Gilchrist, only one field goal in the last 30 minutes of this game for him after a scintillating start. So it's Gist, McCray, Ledbetter, Painter Medley, and Mike Jones on the floor for Maryland. North Carolina counters with May, David Dowell, Jack Emanuel, Marvin Williams, and Raymond Felton. Just another steal. His hands have been quicker to the ball. Ledbetter, a little stop and go, and a poor pass deflected and taken away by Dowell. One of the few mistakes he's made, and Dowell made them pay.
New season high for David Dowell, 10 points. Only other double-figure game this year, Tim, was against Kentucky in that win.
Gist doubled, slapped away by Manuel. North Carolina clamps down defensively. That's a block. And Jack Emanuel will get to the free throw line. Jack Emanuel and David Noel with quality pilfers in the last couple of minutes.
Well, and see what happens here on this one, that Mike Jones, you won't see, he tries to reach for it, and David Noel runs through his body and comes up with the possession. Just out-hustled and out-quick Mike Jones to the basketball.
Just as we were complimenting Ledbetter and the way he was running the offense, 4 straight turnovers committed by the Terrapins, and that leads John Gilchrist back onto the floor along with Obikwei and Travis Garrison. McCray, Gist, and Ledbetter all sit down. But overall, Gary Williams has got to be really happy with the play of Gist, Jones, and Ledbetter off his bench. Mike Lonergan there, the assistant coach, is Gary Williams. We should congratulate him. He was just named the new coach at Vermont. He'll be taking over at the conclusion of this season.
As long time, he was the head coach at Catholic University, won a national championship Division II. Now he gets his chance. Always wanted to be that, get his first head coaching job in D1, and they finally came.
Painter Medley unable to connect. Sean May, the outlet. North Carolina's extended their lead back to 6 after Maryland had tied it at 65. May again claims it with those quality hands, but it's not free by Obikwei. Control to North Carolina. 6th straight double-double for Sean May. Last Tar Heel to do that, Antoine Jameson.
Hey, he is having a first-team All-ACC year, Tim, and no doubt about it, and especially his play over the last half of the season.
There are no chemistry issues with North Carolina this season. I talked to Sean a little bit about that before the game tonight. He had some wonderful things to say about the Tar Heels tradition as Manuel gets the tip in. And the lead back to eight.
Again, the little things that Jackie Manuel brings to you, the ability to get on the offensive glass.
Raymond Felton will pick up that foul, trying to check Gilchrist. I asked Sean May before the game tonight, I said, tell me why this team seems to have such outstanding chemistry. And he discussed a summertime golf outing that Vince Carter puts on, Antoine Jamison, George Lynch, and a few other of the veteran Tar Heels came. And he started talking to this class, this particular class of Tar Heel players, and he said, you know, you guys need to spend more time with one another off the floor as well as on, because your success and your failure as teammates will bring you closer together. And he said they did make a conscious effort this season when practice began in mid-October to do exactly that.
Well, he talked about, and it's just completely opposed to his freshman year, how they just kind of show up and play, and there was that was clearly lacking.
There were cliques developing at that time. And they don't have that issue right now. Roy Williams made them aware of it, and then when the other players came in offering their opinion, they listened. And again, May takes it strong to the hoop. Garrison having all kinds of difficulty trying to deal with Big Sean on the low block.
Well, Maryland has nobody physically who can set up with Sean May. And anytime you're a big and you can flash across the lane and get position, you're that much more difficult to defend. Any big guy on the move, you have an advantage, and he's just so good at catching the basketball and drawing contact.
Now, you know something about double-doubles for post players. It's not easy to go out there and do it 6-7 times in a row. And that's what he's done.
A very, very impressive streak. You know, he and Sheldon Williams, it's a similar situation, have separated themselves from the other post players in the conference.
And frankly, it's what distinguishes teams in college basketball today, because it's such a card-laden game. North Carolina by eight, 4.5 and counting. Kaner Medley leans in. A little body English curled that one through the cylinder. Manuel trying to drive on Kaner Medley, not allowing that baseline to become open. May. Not there. Juwan Williams trying to keep it alive and does. His athletic ability keeps the ball in Carolina's hands.
Ryan got a killer possession, too. If you're Maryland now, 3.5 minutes left, and you made a good defensive stop, and you must come up with the basketball in that instance. And he's just giving them North Carolina another possession. That's dangerous.
Alley-oop from Felton to Sean May. North Carolina, 16 offensive rebounds for 21 second chance points.
Instead of cutting it to six and then possibly three, they've expanded it with eight, you know, just because of a second chance opportunity.
Gilchrist for three. 80 to 75, a two-possession game.
Haven't heard that number in a while.
It took over 32 minutes for him to get back into the scoring column. Felton trying to run him through a variety of screens. Gilchrist having none of it. Shot clock winding down. Felton got away from him. That's a walk.
Timeout. The walking double-double did make a mistake there with an extra step. Oh, but can he deliver off the oop? Plenty of alley and a whole lot of oop.
Howdy, folks. Since 1951, the Earnhardt family's been selling cars and trucks. Although times have changed, what has never changed is the Earnhardt commitment to world-class service and low prices that can't be beat.
At Earnhardt Ford in Tempe, you can buy a new 05 Ford and get 0% financing for up to 60 months or discounts up to $10,200. That's Earnhardt Ford at Baseline and Rural in Tempe.
The Earnhardt name is a name you can trust, folks. That's a commitment from our family to yours. That's Earnhardt. No bull since 1951.
is The Sports List.
With Summer Sanders.
The show that counts down anything
and everything
in the world of sports.
The most shocking upsets. The best sports heroes. The sexiest athletes. The biggest sports scandals. And much more. Hosted by Summer Sanders.
Every night, a new list.
Every night, the new argument. The Sports List. Weeknights on FSN.
Now, there's a place where college never ends. Fox College Sports. The network that brings you the most comprehensive college sports coverage anywhere. With unprecedented live event coverage, coaches' shows, and news from the biggest and the best of the NCAA. This is the network college sports fans always dreamed of. For more information on Fox College Sports, log on to foxcollegesports.com.
ASU fans, find out everything you need to know about your Sun Devils this season on the Sun Devil Insider. Interviews and in-depth features take you inside ASU athletics like no other program on television. The Sun Devil Insider, Wednesday at 6:30 and 10 on FSN Arizona.
Let's take a look at our Staples game summary, Mike. And without McCray, he's been the constant. They wouldn't have even been in a position to make this a close game.
And you know what? It's interesting. They've had no answer for McCray on the perimeter, and Maryland's had no answer for Sean May inside. I mean, right. He's on the point, the paint in this game.
Let's take a look at our Subway hot shot of the game, and it's worth another look. No question about that.
Well, you got it talking that Sean May got lost in the defense. A great pass by Raymond Felton. And that was, you know what? That's a play that Sean May couldn't make last year. I don't think he was in shape enough to make that play with 2.5 minutes left to go in the game. And that's been the difference in him this year.
A big sequence here for Maryland offensively. Need to maintain contact as well as North Carolina handles their offense. They really need to score here. Afekwe. Jones saves it to McCray. That's who you want to have it.
How many times do you see on an offensive rebound in a scattered play, a guy steps up and makes a three, the defense is completely out of sorts.
And Mike Jones kept the ball alive to get it to McCray. Turnover by the Tar Heels. McCray is 5 of 6 from downtown. He has 25 points. A career high for him. He feels it. He and Mike Jones, particularly, have been the difference makers in the second half, along with James Gist, who's out there right now, number 15 for the Terrapins down low.
Well, Jones and McCray, they're matched up well with Manuel and Noel, North Carolina's two best perimeter defenders.
McCray leaves it deep for Jones. Oh, the iron, not only kind, generous.
And Noel got sucked in on the play, and that allowed Jones to get the good look.
Well, if Jones is the trigger, G-Man, then you want to ride that horse the rest of the night.
Well, you know, you've got to find him, and that's what John Gilchrist has done. You've got two hot shooters out on the floor, McCray and Jones. And when you have two options, it's tough for the defense to stay with them. This is on that scatter play, and McCray knocking down the three. And then because of penetration, there's the kick out again, the other look at it. And this is where penetration, and McCray almost traveled that time, but that's where Noel got sucked in, and that was a great find, and boy, you love those home rims, don't
yes.
you?
Yes. I thought they calibrated those equally now.
Three straight three-point baskets for Maryland. Gilchrist, McCray, Jones. That erases a lot of leads.
I think the fans now know that Maryland has been able to pretend that North Carolina was Duke. 81-80, their first lead since 29-28 in the opening half.
First lead doesn't matter. Last lead matters.
Jawan Williams for three. Bang.
Jawan Williams for three.
How many big shots has that young man made in the last couple of weeks? You know, going into the Connecticut game, his numbers had really fallen off for about a 3 or 4 game period, Mike, and then he had an outstanding performance in Hartford in the non-conference win against the Huskies, who, by the way, are playing awfully well right now for Jim Calhoun. And he's just continued that torrid pace in the ACC.
He averaged 3 points a game in that stretch, Timmy, 15 since that over the last four. And this is a shot, this time of game, that Rashad McCants may look for. Instead, they turn to the senior, and Juwan Williams has stepped up.
Something to remember as you look at the numbers on Juwan. Gary Williams had to call a number of timeouts early in the second half, so he's only got one timeout remaining.
We have 1 minute to play.
1 minute left. You have to figure that McCray or Jones are the most likely to touch it at the critical time. Of course, Gilchrist is always a factor.
On the offensive glass, Maryland comes away with it. Tie ball, the arrow to the Terrapins.
And that is important at this stage of the game. Kaner Medley to check in for Maryland. And Gist out.
Kaner Medley for James Gist.
Well, offensive for defensive substitution there.
Jones comes away with it. A floater. Not there. Abekwe tipped it twice and got it to go down.
Wow, what a play by Abekwe. We've seen it a bunch in this half. Maryland's beaten North Carolina off the floor a couple of times, and he missed an easy point-blank tip, but then bailed himself out with a tough left-hander.
And by the way, they haven't had too many put-back opportunities in this game.
And the whole thing starts when David Noel falls down. Abekwe might have gotten away with a push there and then just went back over the top of Sean May.
We knew going in, Mike, that Maryland would give their best effort tonight, that they just seemingly always respond to those titanic teams on their schedule. And there you see the remaining games for both clubs. And they're all very important at this stage for Maryland, trying to work their way into the NCAA tournament season.
North Carolina finishes out at home with those two games and then the all-important season ender with Duke. But all Maryland, if you're in right now, you just need a stop. There's plenty of time left on the clock. They'll have 6 or so seconds coming back.
Capacity crowd at Comcast Center, all on their feet. ACC Sunday Night Hoops coming down to Casey.
I think if you're North Carolina, you take your first best shot and then trust your defense.
Felton all the way to the rack.
Gary Williams in disbelief that he was able to get a layup.
His best scoring moves, Tim, are to his left hand, and he was able to run through some screens and get into the lane. Here he comes off the top, and just Kaner Medley gave up on the play. You've got to stay with Felton. And then Sean May seals off inside, so no shot blockers come in. And that was a great, great drive by Raymond Felton, but he had plenty of help.
How much more comfortable are you as a coach when you know that you've got that kid looking you eye to eye in the huddle at this stage of the game?
Gary Williams, go back a couple of years when Stephen Blake was in that role.
Yep.
I mean, same situation. Hey, look at that. That's a great shot right there. Coach on the bench, coach on the floor.
Yeah, and by the way, with that most recent deuce, his first of this half, he has a double-double. He's dished out 10 on this Sunday night to go along with his 10 points. And with 18.9 remaining, Maryland with a chance to either send it to overtime or try to win it with a three.
I think you got to trust Chris McCray. Let's see how North Carolina matches up, because they're going to have Noel and Emmanuel in on Mike Jones and McCray.
Lineup looks this way. Gilchrist, Kaner Medley, Jones, Abekwe, and McCray. North Carolina with Manuel, Felton, Juwan Williams, David Noel, and Juwan Williams now, on the floor.
Conventional wisdom is you go for the tie at home and try to extend into overtime. Let's see if Maryland tries to take care of business right here.
Gilchrist on the drive. Ball knocked away by Felton. Out of bounds with 6.8 remaining. And another timeout. The final one taken by Gary Williams.
The Terrapins call timeout.
This is when scouting reports really come in and become the major factor at the end of any game.
Those baseline out-of-bounds plays, you focus in on them, and every team goes over them at the at shoot-arounds.
And you can't take a look at it and call a timeout, even if you're Roy Williams now. No timeouts left for either club.
Timeout situation right there. So, I mean, you know, the onus right now, you've got to have a solid guy taking the ball out of bounds, somebody who's got some poise and has that clock in his head.
Well, it's been said for many, many years, Mike, and North Carolina even warms up the way they did when Dean Smith was coaching many years ago and Frank McGuire prior to that. If you think about it, sometimes the most difficult thing to do against a Tar Heels team is get the ball inbound.
That pretty much says it all. Win now and we get to dance later. The fans are very well aware of how important to win against a top team, second in the country, and in the RPI, what it would do for Maryland with a win.
For Maryland right now, aside from getting the ball in, ball screening and their action and getting people open is the most important thing.
Jones. Driving to the basket, pass Manuel, rejected by May. That should do it. North Carolina wins. What a huge win for Roy Williams and company.
And he would be most proud that they did it with defense.
Well, I tell you what, Sean May was an absolute man in this game. He owned the paint. Double-double, points, rebounds, blocks, and none bigger than the one in last play. Now, you got to give Mike Jones credit to try to force the action a little bit, make a play going to the rim and involve the referees. But, boy, this was just a great help-side defensive play by Sean May, cutting off the angle and then keeping it in bounds to Tim, not letting Maryland get control of the basketball and have a second chance.
He had 22 points, Mike, 11 rebounds, 3 blocks, and the last one really saved potential overtime, if not the game.
Like I said, you know, to me, first team All-ACC.
Oh,
no question about it. And a terrific effort for him. And again, making that type of play last year at the end of the game, I don't know if he could have done it, but in so much better shape and condition now. Very active, very athletic.
Roy Williams there, you saw him congratulating, I believe, Mike Lonergan, the assistant coach from Maryland. He's gotten a head coaching job at the Division 1A level. Here's that play again.
But Jackie Manuel keeps him on his hip, drives him right into Sean May and the big fella, protecting the basket.
And it was Raymond Felton's layup with 18.9 remaining that turns out to be the eventual game winner. And the updated standings have North Carolina at 12-2, 24-3 overall, a definite number one seed in the upcoming NCAA tournament, regardless of what happens the rest of the way. For Mike Jaminski, Tim Brando sending it back to our studios in Atlanta for the moment. Fellas?
Well, Timmy B, Mike Jaminski, exactly what we had hoped we would see, a very entertaining basketball game. Welcome into our ACC Sunday Night Hoops studios here in Atlanta alongside the coach Perry Clark, the vet Larry Connolly. I'm Mike Goldberg. We continue our coverage of ACC Sunday Night Hoops, working our way up to the big women's game at the top of the hour, but it's quite simple. The game comes down to Sean May, 22-11 in a game-saving block.
Well, it was, but I also got to give Maryland a lot of credit too, Mike, because they really came back and fought very hard in that second half. Perry, I really thought the way Maryland came back, they were going to win that basketball game, but North Carolina wasn't going to be denied.
Yeah, you're right, Larry. I thought Maryland did a tremendous job in the second half. They shored up their defense. They got really good shot selection. Great second half. Just a great play by a great player in Sean May.
And Maryland still stays on the bubble, and as Tim Brando said, North Carolina in all likelihood locks up their number one seed. We'll get you caught up on all the latest in college hoops from today's action. And coming up top of the hour, a huge battle for ACC supremacy on the women's hard court. Second-ranked Duke Hoach's arch rival and 8th-ranked North Carolina for the regular season championship. Most of our viewers, top of the hour, will see ACC women's basketball. And coming up on the ACC Sunday Night Hoops postgame report, Rock Chalk Jayhawk, but when we look for the dominant Big 12 team, do we still see KU? A colossal Big 12 clash, OSU-KU.